Hey, my name's Harrison, and I'm going to show you how to make a very simple electromagnet. Okay, so these are the materials you'll be needing. You can get all of these at Lowe's. You'll need 50 feet of 18-gauge copper speaker wire, and this comes in two strands, as you can see here on the picture. You'll need a razor blade. You'll need a 5-inch by 1/2-inch iron bolt, which will act as your core. This must be attracted to a magnet, otherwise it won't make a very good electromagnet. You can test this by simply getting a permanent magnet and seeing if it's attracted to this. And finally, you'll need some electrical tape. Okay, so your procedures are fairly simple. Just take your iron rod and lay it out like that. Next, you'll take your copper wire, like this, and you're going to split them down the ends, because they come in twos and you only want them by themselves. So you take your razor blade and you split down the middle about an inch, and then take each by the ends and you just pull all 50 feet apart. Pretty simple. Once you have a length of 50-foot copper wire, like I've already done, like I showed you, you take the end and you strip it with your razor, just, you know, like that. And then you take 5 inches or so, and you put that on the head. And then you wrap it around and secure that there. Once you've done that and secured it, so you can pull on it and it's pretty tight, you just wrap around until you get to the end. It's a lot easier if it's threaded all the way. This obviously isn't. You can also get that at Lowe's. And once you get to the end, you go back over what you've done, and you keep going until you've used up all the wire except 5 inches, which is going to be your other end, which you'll connect to the battery. And then you strip that end, and then, let's just say this is the end here, you're going to bring that back to the same end you started with this one. You're going to twist them, just, you know, two times or so, and then you're going to tape them with electrical tape to the head here so that they stay in place. Okay, well, this is the finished product. It's got all the copper wound around this rod, and I'm going to test it, see if it works. So over here I have a lawnmower battery. I'm not sure how many amps and volts it is, but I think it's 12 volts and something like 5 amps, maybe probably less than that. That's just giving it, you know, a bit more credit than it's worth, but right, and when I connect this, basically what's going on is when electricity flows through a wire, it creates a small magnetic field. When you wrap a lot of wire around a iron rod, it amplifies that field a lot more than it originally would just by itself. And so when I connect this up, this, which is my razor, should stick to this end here. So here it goes. Okay. There we go. Stuck. Try that again. Yep. See if I can get it to stick better. There we go. And stuff like this is generally, it's mostly used in junkyards to pick up cars and stuff like that, because you can control the magnetic field just by the flow of electrons, and so it's much better than a permanent magnet, which you can have problems getting stuff to disconnect from if it's a really strong magnetic field. And it's also used a bit in circuit boards and small stuff like that, like in older TVs, not plasma screen TVs, but certainly older ones, like in cathode ray tubes, stuff like that. And then I'll just do it one more time. All right. Okay, that's it for this design. If you like that, go ahead and rate or subscribe. That was more of a beginner's electromagnet, and I'll be making a much more efficient design, hopefully soon, that instead of using the insulator around the copper wiring, I'll have copper wiring that is a bigger gauge and probably coated so I can have a lot more of it on the iron core. So that's it.